Hello guys, KP Shamino here, and I'm playing for a couple of days now a new game, Fishing Planet, and I like it a lot because I'm a fisher myself, and I was really amazed about the depth of this game. So it's so close to reality, it's unbelievable. It's not just throwing your bobber in with some bait and that's all. No, it's very complicated, like fishing is, if you want to do it good. So I was thinking about making a beginner's guide, and that's what I did. This is the beginner's guide. So first of all, if you do the tutorial good, you come on this map, and this is a map of America. Like you can see, there are 7 locations, and those 7 locations you can fish. At the start you only can fish at one location, that's this location. It's Missouri Mudwater River. So, but other unlock on the level. So here you need to be level 8 in Colorado, here you need to be level 20 in California. So how can you level? By, yeah, I guess catching fish, of course. That's how it goes. So before I'm going more into the location settings, I'm just going to show you guys before you go to the fishing ground what you can do. So first of all, you got here like an icon of a house. Here you can see your equipment. So at the moment I got only one set. I tried to get the second one because it's possible, but it didn't work. So I guess it depends on the level. I'm only level 2. I think how higher the level is, how more setups you can have. So here you can see what you equip. So for example, if you want to equip now a hook 10, just take the hook 10, drag over here and you use it. I want to use bread instead of cheese. Just do it like this. Not complicated, very simple. The thing is, this equipment is in your fishing box. Like you know or not know, fishers always sitting on something when they are fishing. That's not a chair. That's like a box. And in that box, there is the equipment. People that fish know it. So if you're a small guy, you got a small fishing box. If you're getting bigger, you got a bigger fishing box. Yeah, that's not for equipment, that's for beer and all that stuff. So that's a fishing box. And here you can see this icon is your fishing box. Then you got your house, and in your house you got the big equipment that you cannot take on location. Like you can see. And here you see your license. Like in real life, if you want to fish somewhere, you need to have a license. Now, you always start with the basic Missouri license, and you got unlimited access to fish there. If you go somewhere else, you need to buy another license. Okay, here you can see it. Then, the third icon here is the shop. And guys, I was really amazed, and that's what makes this game so good. You got so many options. It's like, it's unbelievable. Like you can see here, you see the rods like this. Here you see the reels, the lines, the bait. In the bait, if you go over the bait, like you take cheese, here you can see what you can catch with your cheese. So you can catch a bluegill, a trout and a catfish. It's very important that you know which bait you need to take. Okay, just check it out, just read a little bit. If you are not a fisher in real life, it's sometimes a little bit, yeah, overwhelming at the start. But fishing is not complicated. It's just a fish, it bites and there it stops. You just need to check it that you got the right line, because if you got a line for 1 kilogram fish and you got 2 kilogram fish, you break your line and stuff like that. Okay. So now we are going back to the map, and we are going to, of course, to our first locations. But first I'm going to show you something. Here at the right you see the location, and here you see the kind of fish that you can catch on that location. So in Missouri you can catch like a bass, you can catch a catfish, you can catch a panfish. So be sure that you got the right bait with you for that location before you start, because you need to fly. Here you can see the travel with an airplane, and here you can see how many days that you want to be there. So here is your money at the right top. So I got 178 I guess it's dollars still. And the truffle costs 20, and if you want to be more than one day too, it costs 10 in the total. Just that you know it. So you just need to take here travel. And now we are going to the fishing place. And I'm getting already a little bit excited because, yeah, it's a fisher. It's like a hunter, you know. Okay, we entered the fishing site, and here you can see this is very important. So, like humans, fish don't eat the whole day. When they are more active, they eat more. So, if it is warm, they don't eat a lot. If it is raining, they eat a lot. Do you know why? Because there is a lot of oxygen in the water, and fish get more active, and yeah, they need to eat more. And here you can see, so day one, you can see on the line which time is the best to catch fish. So between 5 a.m. and 9 a.m. day, you got the most chance to get the fish, and at the evening too. Very important that you know that. So be sure that you always fish in the spike moments of the day that the fishes are the most hungry. Okay, so just check it out and be sure that you fish on. Okay, now we are going to fish. I'm going to show you guys the mechanics. It's not complicated. If you want to check all the keys by yourself, they are here too. So just read them. I'm going to just show you guys how you need to fish, how you need to speed up the time and stuff like that. How you need to strike, how you need to reel in. Stuff like that. So first of all, you need to move around with your arrows. So it's not a gigantic place. You can run around, so it's a small place. So just take a nice spot that you like, and then you need to throw your bobber into the water. But first of all, I'm going to show you guys the settings that you need to use. So you just need to push E from inventory, so push E, and then you will see your setup that you are using. Okay, here you can see too the bait, what you can catch with it and what you don't catch with it. So we are just use bait, the cheese bait. For other fact you don't need to do a lot, but this is very important. This is the distance between your bobber and your bait. Because not every fish lives on the same place in the water. Like you got a lot of fish that live on the bottom because they eat from the bottom. Then you got a lot of fish that live on the surface because they eat from the surface. So it's very important that the depth here to catch a certain fish. So just try to do some stuff with it. Like for example, you can start at 20. And then you go, you see what you can catch. Then you go to 30 or 50, you see what you can catch. Remember it, and then you know which kind of fish you need to, that you can catch on that depth. Okay? Your hook, your reel. Yeah, not complicated. So that's your setup. Now I'm going to show you guys how you need to throw with your bobber. So first of all, if you just click your left mouse, it just throws like this. You see it? Okay. If you want to use your reel to get it back in, you need to push button one, the left button of your mouse again. Just keep the push in and you will see it goes slow. Okay. If you want to throw a little bit farther, like every fisherman, because everybody wants to throw very far with the rope, you just push F11, like this. You just need to push the left button of the mouse and keep it pushed in. And you will see an energy bar, and how more the energy bar is full, farther you're going to throw. Look. And here we go. It's a lot farther. Okay. If you want to, you just saw that I reeled back my bobber, but it went a little bit slow. If you want to speed up that, you just need to roll with your mouse roller, and you will see at the right bottom of my screen that it will change. How more you got, the faster it goes. Watch now. It's a lot faster. Like this. Okay, I always play like this. Because it doesn't matter. Okay, another thing that you can see here is the drag setting. If you are not a fisherman, I don't think that you know what the drag setting is of a reel. That means a reel got like a resistance on the line. If a fish pulls a line and your reel resistance is very firm, you got more chance that the line breaks. If you lower the resistance and the reel can give more line when the fish pulls, it's most possible that your line don't break and you got more chance to catch the fish. That's the drag setting of a reel. Maybe it's not that easy to understand, but I think you guys know it a little bit. If you are trying to catch bigger fishes, I would suggest that you put the resistance a little bit lower, so that the fish can still swim a little bit away, come back, swim a little bit further, come back, and you need to tire the fish. That's like real fishing. It's not that you can just take a fish of 10 kilograms to the shore, put it on the shore like in 2 seconds. No, it doesn't work like that. Here it's just the same. Then at the right you see like a kind of energy bar. I don't know what it is, like a lot of boxes. Those boxes, if you catch a fish, you will see that they are going to light up. That means the strength that the fish uses on your line. If it goes to the top, your line breaks. Simple like that. So you need to try to calibrate it a little bit that your line don't break. Okay. So that was throwing in, throwing out. Let's throw one time more in. So, like you guys can see at the right, you see my bobber. And the bobber is now, it's not moving a lot. If you see the bobber moving very fast, you need to push, you need to strike. Push the right bottom of your mouse, like this, and you strike. Do you see my rope going? That's how you do. Okay. At the left top, you see the time, you see the temperature, you see the day. Not complicated. Another thing that is very important, for example, you are fishing in a really bad... Oh, something eating from my bait. No, it's not... maybe. Look. They are just pushing against my bait. He doesn't know what he needs to do. Yeah, now he's gone. Yeah, I got him. Do you see now at the right? The resistance? I need to wait a little bit. Yeah, that was close. Ah, I got a catfish. That's the first time that I got a catfish. Right in the movie. So this is a catfish. Now you saw all the stuff happening. So I'm going to release it. Because I never eat fish, so... I always release the fishes because they are way too beautiful. Okay, what was I saying? Okay, if you are now, you want to speed up a little bit because you're in a part of the day that the fish don't bite really well. You just push, let me check it, you just push T. And if you push T, you can just fast forward the time. Very handy sometimes. And that's it for this guide. It's not complicated. Just be sure that you got the right bait, that you got the right depth. And that's it. It's not a lot that I can say more. So guys, have really fun with this game. I liked it a lot, and I'm very happy. I just got my first catfish in the movie. It's always the same with my movies. Something always happens, but I didn't expect it. So have fun and happy fishing, and see you later, guys. Bye bye.